I'm going to quickly show you how to create a Beeswarm plot like this one in Excel. Now, I'm working with the data from this week's Makeover Monday, but I'm only really interested in the total score, so I'm going to delete all these columns. Let me resize. And what we want to do to start is to group these into score bins. So let's call this score bin. Let's add a bin size somewhere over here. Let's make it 20 to start with. And to group these, it's very simple. We can use the mround function. This number, this multiple, fix that. Press enter. And there we go. You'll see this is into the 520s. These are in the 500s. These are in the 480s, etc. And now we want to count the frequency for each bin. So we can use COUNTIF. This is our range. Fix that. This is our criteria. Apply it down. 1 520, 3 500s, 4 480s, and so on and so forth. So let's try to plot these. I'm going to select the score bin and the frequency and insert a scatter plot. And you'll see that we're getting sort of the shape of the distribution here, but what we actually want, for example, here is to have three periods so that each one represents a data point in what is otherwise known as a unit histogram or a dot plot. So what we essentially want is for this to be a 1, this a 2, and then this stays as a 3 so that we have them like this. But I'm going to undo. Let's do that using a formula. So I'm going to call this, let's call it bin count. I'm going to use COUNTIF again. I'm going to start with the range by just selecting this cell. And if I press the colon, you'll see that it converted into a range. And I'm going to fix the first D2. That way, the top will stay fixed. And as I apply this down, the bottom of the range will stay dynamic. So I'm going to count the number of times. It's not the frequency, actually. It's the score bin. I'm going to count the number of times it's appeared so far as we go down. So we'll get a 1 here. We'll get a 1 here. Once we reach this point, we'll have 2 500, so we'll get a 2. So if I do it like this, close that out, apply it down, you'll see that we get the rising count by score bin. So let's go back here, shift this to the bin count, and we get the Wilkinson dot plot, which is really a histogram in which you can see every individual item. Now, you might want to stop there. I think that's perfectly fine. In fact, it's a bit more intuitive than the Beeswarm, but let's just continue and see how we can get to the Beeswarm. And if you think about it, let me move this over here. All we need to do is offset all of these so that they are centered or symmetric around the 0 point. So I need to move these down by roughly about half their value. So what I'm going to do, add another column here. Let's call this position. I'm going to grab each one, and I'm going to subtract half of the total frequency for that bin. So divide by half, apply it down, and if I move this over here, you'll see that we get the Beeswarm correctly, but it's not converging around 0. It's actually converging around 0.5. So let's adjust for that. Apply it down, and there we go. Now let's just get rid of these grid lines. We can move this so that it's at the bottom. We can get rid of the shape outline so we don't have the line across the 0, and we don't really need these. Let's get rid of that. And check this out. If I move the bin size around, you'll see that everything will update accordingly. Isn't that cool? Now you can stop there, maybe format this chart, but what I also did is actually add the kernel density on top of this so we get a clear indication of what the underlying distribution is for the data here. And to do that, add two more. Call this KDE, which is short for kernel density estimate. And I actually had to look up the formula online. You can check it out on this website here at exceldemi.com. Thank you to Alok Paul for giving me the formula, which I actually got right here. So if we apply the same formula here, we'll actually need the sample size as well. I'm just going to really quickly count these values. Now let's add the formula. Let's apply it down. And now let's go to add another series here. Call it KDE. The X values in this case is actually going to be the total score. And the Y value is going to be the KDE here. Press OK. Press OK. And now all we need to do is put this on a secondary axis. So let me go to combo here. Go to scatter. Scatter. This on the secondary, maybe add the smooth lines. Let's add both axes here. There we go, we're getting there. We'll see the distribution here. All we need to do is mirror it on the other side. Let me call this KDE minus, and that's going to be that times -1. Apply that down. Again, let's add that series now. Press OK. Press OK. It automatically got inserted into that secondary axis, and now we can see the kernel distribution on top of our Beeswarm. We can get rid of these now again. Maybe want them without an outline. And once again, if we modify the bin size, then everything gets adjusted accordingly. Now all we need to do is add some formatting, make the dots bigger, make the lines matching colors, and maybe do something with our x-axis here and add a title, and we're good to go.